This might get graphic.
What?
We might put in some graphics, some animation and stuff.
Gotcha.
Well, the sleepover comes to an end.
But only because it has to.
Sometimes things have a certain shelf life.
Name those things. Name those things.
Boy Meets World.
Great show. Does it hold up?
I think it has a shelf life that has reached its...
I think a character like Mr. Feeny could live on forever. You could take somebody like that, plug him into every decade of every show, and he'd survive.
You're right.
But Ryder Strong's character?
Sean?
Yes. I feel like he could only survive in that show in that time period. You put Ryder Strong on... Well, you put Ryder Strong on a medical drama. I'm watching just because I'm like, that's a kid from Boy Meets World. I wonder if he can make the jump.
Also, I haven't seen him in so long.
To drama.
But I actually called you here to ask you what you did in the bathroom.
I pooped.
Why did you flush it? I told you we only flush peas.
Can you please appease to my PP request?
All right, good. Now that we got that warm up in, let's have a sincere conversation for a sec.
Okay.
Ryder Strong, really? Yeah. You know, people do that stuff where like they get on track and they go, take it.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
You telling me you really had sex with the waitress? Huh?
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. We call that the parenthetical acting.
Yeah.
So, Adam, how do you feel?
I don't remember going to bed. I find that the amount of weed I take when I hang with you is appropriate. What took me up a notch, the little puffs that I was sneaking out back on the patio. So look, a patio with a beach backdrop is so conducive for taking a couple puffs.
Who said that?
Elliot Chang, the comedian.
Oh, right. That's, yeah.
Yeah. Put funny. Up a picture, Instagram handle.
Yeah.
Elliot's a funny kid. Haven't seen him in a minute. That's the thing about this quarantine.
Soundtrack.
I felt good. There were waves. I wanted to stay down here and just watch TV with you and kick it for a while, but I was too high. I needed to go to sleep. And I was like, if I don't get five, I'm going to be a mess tomorrow.
That's Adam Ray from Talent Fresh Agency.
I could just feel it. Otherwise, but there was also a point of me that was like, dude, I would love to put on like, you know, Chippendales Rescue Rangers or You've Got Mail, something with some heart and just chill because these couches are comfy. It's a great hang room in here. And this is where we were at the end of the night. And the way I was positioned and you were positioned, you know, just kicking back, excited to be in the moment. because we had built up a great high. We had had a lot of good laughs, so it was such a nice way to kind of end the night and being like, ah. But I think as I took my final, like, ah, let's chill out, that went.
And the next thing you remember, you were asleep.
Hello.
There's one person in here.
No, don't do it. You're actually coughing on my food.
It's me, Bald Trith Worthington. What do you think?
Yeah, pretty much. But something in me went from 0 to 60 when I took a what was supposed to be a calming breath. Does that ever happen when you go, everything's gonna be fuck?
And then I was Ryan are strong in a drama. I got high. I haven't been high in a while, and I got real high last night.
Yep.
Plus, I had adrenaline going through me from like setting the laughs, setting stuff up, doing the bathroom thing, and then taking way too long to come down here. And by the time we were down here, I was so high.
There was a vaccine.
Okay. And I set up all these equipments, and then I looked at the footage, and this, my camera and the last one was in front of the, it just looks bad.
What does? What we did down here?
Yeah.
Usable.
Yo, it's usable. Okay. I'll be posting it. Okay. I'm just not, like, I put a lot of time and energy into making sure the audio sounds good. I get the good wires. I bring enough lights and I set everything up and I bring everything. And then when it came to it, I didn't do a test one on the roof, but I think it's okay. But the one in here, it just doesn't look great. And there's a big part of me that is like, oh, fuck. But also something about doing this podcast, there are some that either... Like the interview, it doesn't go great.
Yeah.
Some go great.
Yeah.
Something's out of focus. Shit happens. And I've become more okay with that. And I think that's a big thing that the podcast is, I'm being sincere, like a big thing that the podcast has taught me is I want to do everything a certain way. And sometimes it doesn't come out that way, but it doesn't change the fact that this was so much fun.
Yeah.
I also think it's, I don't know, this is going to be an episode that I'm, our 2.0, which is, Adam Ray 2.0, check it out. It's one of the favorites of the podcast, if not the favorite. And that and Dad Teddy 2.0. Those are the two 2.0s, which is not to be mistaken with the two seconds. Kevin and
Yep.
But.
I get what you're putting down.
Wait, what was the point I was making? Oh, what I wanted to say was that like 2.0, I was embarrassed before posting it. Like I almost didn't want to post it. And I had people tell me to post it. I feel that way about this one a little bit.
Oh, I think there's a lot of... There's a lot that people are going to be able to find in what we've done over the last 2 days that's going to make them smile. And I don't know about you, but I get a lot of very sweet, sometimes overwhelmingly candid about how whatever bullshit I'm putting out during this time is getting them through it. And I think a lot of comedians, if you're consistent and you're committing to what you're doing, are getting similar responses. But I don't know. I don't check their DMs. but it's fair for you to think that, oh, this wasn't perfect.
But also I looked at it and don't do whatever, who cares? I've accepted Great. What I look like. All right, maybe don't. But I look so ugly in these.
Oh God!
I don't ever think I'm gonna look at it and be like, "Damn, look at what I look like." But I look at this one, and it's
who are you, Lori Loughlin in prison?
Adam, I'm being vulnerable.
Added some cricket noise, and then a cricket in the back going, "You suck."
Okay, it's like an old piccolo.
Look, I was not assessing your looks in any of these episodes.
But I'm just talking to you about insecurity at this
for
moment.
Sure.
Insecurity in something where I am saying, whether it's the way I look and or how funny or not funny or loud or high or whatever it is, it's interesting that I have these mix of feelings of like, I'm so embarrassed about a product sometimes while still saying, hey guys, look.
Yeah.
It's like, if you had a pimple, you'd be hiding it. I have a pimple and I'm scared of people seeing it, but I'm saying, will you mind promoting this?
You mind popping it for me, audience?
Well, it's a different metaphor.
But the same idea.
I think that you back, didn't understand the metaphor
holiday
I meant,
belts.
And that confuses me.
No, I think...
Holiday belts?
Yeah.
Whatever happened to Eric Matthews?
Who?
Mr. Thaney?
I think there's something to be said about adjusting, accepting, and having the comedy be first. That's where I was rule. Last night.
Comedy first.
Last night I go,
is it funny?
Yeah. And I was like, shit, dude, I thought about the way I was getting into the tub and how awkward it was and how it was.
You could keep talking.
How it was going to be, how I probably didn't look the best. But then I go, I bet this is really funny. And I started laughing because I let go of the concerns that don't matter. It's like why some kids make such great actors is because they have no actor concerns. They have no extraneous thoughts or things to get in their way. You know,
I feel like Sean Hunter would be a good doctor.
I feel like Ryder Strong could be a patient, like on a Grey's Anatomy. Like they bring him in and they're like, we need two CCs.
Oh yeah, he would have been a guest star in house.
Two CCs and four high Cs. And Ryder Strong goes, my leg. And they go,
yeah,
you're going to be fine, son. Where's your father? He goes, I don't have a father.
All right.
And they go, Jesus Christ, that's a lot of info real quick. We haven't even done the opening credits. And he goes, you asked, bitch. Yeah. And then they wheel him into the back and they go, we got to cut this guy's dick off. And somebody goes, what? Sorry, leg.
So, Adam, how long have you been doing comedy?
Yeah, a couple years.
Yeah, it feels like more than that. Adam?
Yeah.
Adam, I want to talk for real about this process with you, right, and the process of podcasting in general or podcasting in Sargent. But one of the two forms.
So saw that one coming and still looked right at you while you said it.
And? Oh, really? Yeah. I thought it was really, really smart. And
It was just...
No, I'm joking. like, I had that one line. The only reason I wanted to do a third podcast was I forgot to do that. Oh, man. There was something that I wanted to do last night that I forgot about.
Tell me about last night on iTunes everywhere, hosted by Adam Ray. It's a podcast. We've had guests on like Rick Glassman, Sandra Bullock, Bill Burr, LeVar Burton. Oh, fuck. Connect Four.
So maybe if we have time. But look at the size of this thing.
Yeah, there's a lot of things I wanted to do last night that slipped my mind. I wanted to take a walk on the beach.
Yep.
Wanted to play. There's a guitar. I wanted to play that.
I'm just a little weird about using people's stuff. I wouldn't want someone coming into my house and I don't even know whose place this is. Least we could do is respect the fact that we're not using their guitars, or should I say their Sargents.
I think the audience would love if I played a song at some point. But
what do you guys think?
Yeah.
I see that you really want to, and you know, you're my guest. So go for it.
But okay. Oxnard, California is a place where people get high with their friends. We have bagels downstairs. But do we have jam? Do you have jam? If not, that's okay. I'll go to the store. California's where I go when I get out of the show.
And my dad says, hey, do you want to go to a late night diner? I'll bring the car around. But then you must tell your mom that we're not coming home. And then when I get home, and then when we get home, I'm gonna pack my stuff. It's a long way home. It's a long way home.
That's Adam Ray with Oxnard. It's a long way home. Adam, thank you so much for popping by the studio.
Man, it's great to be here.
What?
That was my,
why wouldn't you just be
that
you?
Was my, that was my, I don't know. That was my,
it didn't sound like the guy singing.
That was the cool guy trying to be on the radio. When he's like, that was my hit, Oxnard. It's a long way home.
That sounds like a guy that's... that's trying to fool people into thinking he's deaf.
Yeah. By the way, no joke. Here's what deterred me from even pulling the guitar out last night. I'm on the patio.
What was that noise that you did? But what was the point of it? What were you?
That's me trying to be like, whoa, pulling the guitar out. Easy, easy.
Oh, as if it was a dick.
I don't know.
Oh, you thought the sergeant thing didn't land. Okay, private.
All right, and we're back. But this woman literally says last night, and I want to hear how you would handle this, because this is just a...
Do you?
This is a classic...
I don't think you want to hear anything.
Neighbor nuisance, right?
CNN.
She might have been... Her name might have been Nancy Nuisance, but guess what? Either way, N, period N, is above her bathroom window. So...
Jesus Christ.
I sit down on the patio with the guitar, and she literally goes like this. She walked...
Are you in frame?
She walked in her house... Legit. She walked in her house legit when I sat down on the patio with the guitar. So right when I sit down and I go like this, I go, And she goes, oh, God. And I go, I look down because she's below on street level. I'm up on the patio. She goes, and she's standing in the door. She goes, you're not going to play your guitar now, are you? Swear to God.
Imagine.
Yeah. And I just go, I go, oh, yeah, but just like.
Okay, all right.
Just like this soft. And she goes, my bedroom is literally right there. And I go, I look down, I go, it's 10:24 p.m. I go, this is the world we're living in. People
hey,
shut things.
Man, shut up.
All right.
Just shut the fuck up. All right. I mean, have you never had a friend before? You know, last night I was getting high and I said to Betty, I told Betty last night, I said, you know, I haven't had a sleepover since I was a kid. And at those times, it was hard for me to have friends. And I still have this feeling of, I don't know, does he like me? I've never felt this way.
Wow.
But there was something about a sleepover thing where if you want to go to bed, go to bed. Like there was this insecure, I've been having an odd insecure moment this past little bit. And I'm realizing something. You don't have any friends. Watch out. You don't have any friends, and that's why you're always coming around my podcast shitting on all my guests. No, well, that'll be an animated thing, but I do want to be serious when I say, shut up, dude.
Yeah, and I want to be serious when I say, I hear you.
Uh-huh.
I get what you're all about. And, you know, did your friends... at sleepovers when you were a kid, how early did they go to bed? Because that's a tell
it
for how invested
it
they
wasn't
were in the
just sleepovers. It was this idea of making plans with a friend. I used to want somebody to come over on the bus. Did you have that? Where they come over after school, you get a note, they
that
get
was
to come
the
over on the bus.
Yeah.
And then you just know all day, it doesn't matter because at 3 o'clock, he's coming over on the bus.
Yeah.
And then sometimes I would want my friends to come over and they couldn't because their parents were stricter than mine. And I used to have, I would say, could my mom talk to your mom? And I'd have my mom talk to their mom.
Would you ever lie?
Would I lie? About what?
Oh, I definitely called my friend once and said it was cool if, without asking my mom, that he could come over. So his mom brought him over. My mom was like, hi, Pam, what's going on? And she's like, oh, Adam said Ethan could come over. And she's like, no, we're leaving.
No, I didn't lie. And I found out later, at least I realized now looking back, it was the kids that didn't want to come over.
Oh, fuck.
And the mom.
That burns.
The mom, I think, I'm pretty, I mean, come on. Everyone said
did
no
you have a cool house?
Time. Cool enough. Yeah.
What was your big selling point?
Let me finish.
That's important. And the fact that you don't want to, that you're skipping over it, Trump style, means that you didn't have a lot to offer.
We only had one sink and no toilet.
There it is.
My brother was 2.5 years older than me, probably still is. And he would sometimes get physical with my friends in a way like big brother, but like I'm the little brother, not this guy, John Richards, who's coming over who brought his Zelda so I could help him get the hammer, and I feel like I have value and he's getting something out of it.
Right.
But now Matt's wrestling him.
And that was not in the brochure of the Rick
Glassman.
Oh,
it's in the brochure. Okay. But it wasn't in the brochure.
We're back.
Okay. And also I would get like I would like to play wrestle a lot and just
yeah, most young boys do.
Some of them don't, but they don't tell you, or they do tell you, and you think they're joking.
John Richards, did he go, I guess I am on their turf. I have to play by their rules.
I just remember John Richards.
Bleeding?
The friendship happened. We've always been, I mean, I haven't talked to him in years. Shout out to John. I'll put his Instagram handle up here. But I remember that he used to come over, and I would go over, and then it got to a point where he would just have me come over. And then it was just nothing. So I was part of the problem too. But I do remember, why does his Zelda keep erasing? Why does that keep needing getting the hammer for him? And if I had a cartridge that kept erasing, wouldn't I get a new cartridge or not try and try to beat it without turning it off?
Yeah, maybe they couldn't afford it.
They had a couple of bathrooms. But the thing I was bringing up was that
bathrooms were big. You could that was a tell. More than two bathrooms, you're like, fuck, these guys are rich.
I remember what it was how many TVs do they have?
Mm.
They have a TV in every room.
TV in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Check their garage.
I've never seen a kitchen TV that made me want to watch it.
Well, take that thought and get ready to flip it, Rick, because today we've got the TV for you. Okay, TV's in the bedroom. Check. TV's in the garage. Double check. TV's in the kitchen. Auga. It's time to close that fridge and open up your mind to 42 inches of, easy Cheryl, of pure HD. We're talking TV screens that money can't even...
Wait, why? Just be real.
I don't know.
You were selling something.
Yeah.
And then as soon as you said 42 inches Cheryl, you got a little nervous and then you took a pause. We'll show it. And then you were out.
I want to play an infomercial actor in a movie with Ryder Strong. He can do drama so much because those people are so... I used to do a joke that was like, I want to find a woman that's as easily amused as the women on those infomercials.
Yeah.
Because the guy will be... She's like, and how long does the pasta take to cook? And he goes, 7 minutes. And she goes, oh my God. God. And I was just like,
when they taste it, they know it's good before they have their og ready fight. So, and the trick is to not oversell, to make it believable. You can't right off the bat say it's good. The move is first you have to make a face with a face of how good it is. You have to shake your head no that you don't believe it. And then you have to say it.
You've done the commercial eating things, yeah?
No. Wait, this can't be the same pasta that we just made.
Take another bite, Rick.
But this tastes like it was cooked for, I don't know, 3 hours. I can't leave. Somebody take this away from me. I'm going to get fat and fucking cheat on my partner.
That's the idea. It tastes like it's been in the oven for 3 hours, but it's only been in there for 3 minutes. Sorry, I've got COVID. There's something about pasta that we don't give enough attention to. The flavor. You've done a you've been in so many great commercials.
Oh, thanks, Adam.
My favorite one is the one where you play two parts. I think it's a Wendy's commercial.
It's Tupac, and I don't want to show a clip of that because the times have changed, and there were some choices that the set department made, you know, costume, makeup.
The outfit's weird, but you still rocked it. Have you done the eating things? Oh, you eaten that one, don't you?
I did a KFC commercial.
Mmm, Kentucky Fried Chicken. I think you mean MKFC?
Come see into the delicious world of KFC's $20 for...
And I did a McDonald's chicken sriracha commercial.
Did you eat in both those?
It's topped with crispy onions, fresh baby spinach, and kale.
Onions and baby green.
That's not all. They decided to turn it up even more.
Up, up, and up.
They created an exclusive sriracha mac sauce with just the right kick of spice.
I ate in both of those. And then I also did something that you are, is your bread and butter, pun intended, which is I did five VO spots for McDonald's, including the just the, you know, the dunking of the chicken in where I'm not in it.
For a limited time, McDonald's is taking up its sauce game with sriracha mac sauce. Take things up by dipping your McNuggets in this creamy sauce with just the right amount of spice. And how do we take it up even more? By offering a 20-piece McNuggets for just $5.
It's just the, you know, you do this a lot, but...
You just did the sound?
Yeah, they had somebody do it, and I went... I did the five-piece chicken nugget, is, you know, whatever it was. And I listened to it, and I thought, that's pretty good. Like, this is what it sounds like.
Was it like...
When doves fly, fly, fly. That was my Tupac.
Oh, okay.
But you were talking about El Pollo Loco when I play Twins?
Yeah.
I feel like I don't even know you anymore.
And they cut back.
Yeah, it's an art. You see the people that eat stuff in commercials and really taste it, and you go, God, if you're jealous of that person's mouth, you know they did the job.
You know, it's interesting. We're directed. Adam, do you have something? Because
no, I smoked weed last night.
You
don't tell my dad.
You have to put four fingers on the sandwich to make the sandwich look like it's a lot. You go like this, it looks like a little piece of shit. But I have big hands, so I had to do it like this. So they, someone keeps moving me over to get it to the right spot.
Yeah.
And then they come over in between every take and spray the lettuce to make it look like it's wet. And if you open the sandwich, they have toothpicks to have the, it's not a piece
of
cheese.
So you have to eat around the toothpicks.
I wouldn't eat that. I didn't eat that. I actually made a mistake. I ate at KFC with a spit bucket, but I can't eat the cheese and the ketchup.
You wouldn't just eat the KFC?
I would have to turn. Oh, the KFC, there were so many takes.
Oh, yeah.
But the McDonald's one, I couldn't eat that sandwich. I would have to turn it down.
So they spray the lettuce, huh?
In between, there's three people working on the side to build. They use so many different sandwiches because they want
vegetable fluffers.
Vegetable fluffers.
By the way, they're playing Coachella next year. Secondly,
they're not a real band, right?
No.
Yeah, it sounds good.
It does sound good. I have never seen a McDonald's commercial and been like, whew. How come the lettuce is so dry?
But that's the thing. That's the thing about a good video sandwich. You only notice if it looks gross.
The cheese is always well lit, and I know that.
And it's multiple pieces of little cheese that's toothpicked in. Like if you were to open it up, it would be like Thomas Jefferson bald.
Yeah,
with the triangles.
Because they always have the little corner sticking out. Like if you're having
corner sticks.
Yeah, like if your feet are the way your feet sometimes hang out, just poking out from the comforter like this,
yeah.
Which if you're, you know, which some people go, oh, that's the person's way of letting their significant other know, hey, maybe suck on my toes. And that's what I'm talking about. An invention like this seems astronomically impossible to buy, but put down the phone, pick up the wallet, because it's time to invest in
pick
something.
Pick up the phone and the wallet. If you need them to call.
We need you to call right now. The number on the screen. Change your life. Change your kid's life.
Adam,
I know
do
they're
you
looking-
feel that you do so many voices because you just don't know who you really are?
All the time.
And with that, do you want...
If you're asking young Adam, probably that's why I did a lot of voices. But that's why, yeah, of course. Also, it was fun. It made people laugh.
I'm not asking young Adam. I'm asking young Sheldon. Ladies and gentlemen, from young Sheldon on ABC,
oh, wow.
Please put your hands together for...
Ian Armitage.
And we do remember to do voiceover to... I don't know the name. little autistic goblin comes in. All right. We did have a good time last night. Met some people on the beach, played some volleyball.
Played some volleyball on the beach. It's always fun when you can talk to a stranger and they go along with just something crazy. Especially in these times, I feel like most people I meet or run into or even talk to, it just seems like everyone's trying to avoid each other, at least around here.
That's good.
Definitely seen videos. Buddy sent me one on Instagram last night in Nashville. It's just open. And
what does it matter where he was when he sent it?
Just giving context to the story, like, because I said here in California, I feel like.
But where was the video? The video also took place in Nashville?
No, the video took place in Nashville.
Oh, I thought you were saying he was in Nashville when he sent it.
He was. And so
that seems pretty coincidental.
He
was in Nashville and the video.
Yeah.
Do you think maybe it's something that was staged?
Huh? I'll tell you what wasn't staged. My love for this product. I want to be in one of those so bad.
Yeah.
Talking to those guys on the beach was a gamble, but it paid off.
The last time you played, hey. Holy shit, have you been there? When's the last time you played air volleyball? Follow me. You want two? One game, air volleyball. Air volleyball, just 1 point.
Win.
What's your name, man?
Miguel. I'm Rick.
Adam.
Hey, I mean this with all due respect. You're going down.
All right.
Okay. Nice. What do you guys want to play to? Play to three.
Stay close to the back, bump the front one.
All right, volley for ball. Up, double dime. Up, double dime. Two, two.
Whoa, whoa, back, field, back, field, back to the front.
Too close, too close.
That's you guys.
All right, we serve it up.
All right. Back to the front, double dime.
Back to the front, double dime. Upsy daisy. Two come the swabs.
Okay. Cold play up front. Woo!
Hey! Oh, my bad. Your serve.
Yeah, that's you guys.
They're up one. Sandwich. Enjoy.
With a side of fuck off fries. Got him. We're good. He left.
Ah, fall.
Good hit though, good hit.
Take it over.
Take your time, double dime. Sailboat. Bird fly.
You guys hungry?
No, not yet.
Oh, because you're about to get a knuckle sandwich.
Okay.
You decide to kiss my dick. Oh.
Oh,
yeah. Here, sir.
No coping rules.
Oh. Shit. Oh. Give me the ball.
Yeah. Now you try. Who the fuck is that? What are you, a ninja? I don't think so, guy.
Oh. Break it up. Get up. Damn it. Good shot, dude.
You blacked out. You lost.
Alright, good game, boys.
It's 2028.
Oh, good game, guys.
We had to eat a snuffle sandwich.
Oh,
good game.
I'm
guys.
Too tired to play one by two. That's you.
Yeah.
Good game. No, COVID rules.
COVID rules. Good job.
Oh. Wow. Biden. 2020.
Biden.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Bye, guys. Goodbye. Now,
what do I love about the beach? Three things. Friendship, sports, competitiveness, adrenaline, sand. Jumble it up into a fucking beach soup and toss the frisbee to your friend.
Fuck. All right. Well, let's get out of here.
Those guys ate our shit, man.
Later, fellas. Did you get your COVID results back?
results?
Positively negative.
Oh. So negative, right?
Negative.
Okay, good.
Hey, do you want to airfish?
And that's why you got to be around people that are willing to jump in the bid boat and take risks.
It's important to know that for our air volleyball, these people we kept. I mean, we were set, we weren't wearing them. We had masks and sure we had needed them, but we kept distance. I still don't want to be. I don't mean this promoting like I have a civic duty that anyone's listening to, but I do not want to be around people still. It is nice, but I'm not that way. We got tested. But I'm still like...
Well, it's still a real thing.
Yeah. But being outside, which I'm not often anyway, let alone like on a beach where it's big and there's people you don't know, there is something like nice to connect with those boys. And they stayed over in a separate room.
Yeah.
And we did a podcast with them. And... we don't, they speak Spanish. We speak English. We didn't quite understand each other.
Yeah, I took 3 years in high school. So I go, how is this going to hold up?
Right.
I know, here's what I still remember from Spanish 3.
Let me, can I guess? Yeah. Oh, 3. That's 2 of it. I was going to say using the bathroom when your birthday is, but that's 1.
Puedo ir al baño?
Por favor.
Can I use the bathroom? Yeah, yeah, por favor, if you want to add a please, if you want to be polite.
Why is everyone learning a biblioteca? Is it because it's school is library, or is it a fun way to say?
Fun way to say.
5 syllables.
Me gusta jugar al fútbol.
Yes, my best friend's name is football. Me cumpleaños es el, and I don't want to tell people, but if they want to find out, they could go to patreon.com/takeyourshoesoff.
Oh, yeah, we did a Patreon.
Yeah.
I would make videos in Spanish class. I did videos a lot to get out of doing the actual projects.
I did videos all the time. Mini DV camera?
Yes. And
do you have any fun ones that you could set up and I could cut to a clip? I wonder what I have.
Yes.
I used to do them all the time.
Fuck, we have so many. Yes, I do. I have one. There was a book report freshman year of high school. And Mr. Barker was my teacher, and I read the back of the book. The book was called Summer of the Monkeys, where a kid went into the jungle, got lost, found a family of monkeys, I guess like Jungle Book style, and that became, he lived with them and hung out with them, and it was Summer of the Monkeys.
Is it kind of like Planet of the Apes meets Hansel and Gretel, but like in a family?
Hansel and Gretel, the kids got lost, and the woman tried to like eat their house.
You know Hansel and Gretel, I found out, was eyebrows. Jewish propaganda, where the witch was a Jew. And Hansel and Gretel, these blonde German Aryan boy and girl,
wow,
are just playing, wandering through the forest. I've been hanging with some penguins, and boy, are my fins tired. And
your orphans are tired?
My fins.
Oh, I was like, that's penguins and orphans.
Yeah, we know. I just don't want to, I don't know. You don't know if people are going to hear something.
Yeah,
but,
they are.
Anyway, yeah, Hansel and Gretel are walking through the forest.
That seems like a far-fetched
idea. No. I think this is, I mean, I don't want to put this out there as fact. It's something I heard that was interesting, but I also feel like, I don't remember. I feel like I looked into it, whatever that means, like Google search or something. I really think there's something to it. And the witch is like an old Jewish woman with Jewish woman posture. I mean, they were spot on there. And she's baking cookies, you know, probably unleavened. And she eats them. And it was in a way to make to scare the Aryans from the Jews.
Jesus.
Well, that's what they were preaching.
Yeah. So
you made a school project.
Yeah. So Summer of the Monkeys. I did a talk show where I played this host, and I had on Jonathan Taylor Thomas, who my buddy played. He's Asian.
What do you mean you had him on?
I had him on the show because we said Jonathan Taylor Thomas played the kid in the movie Summer of the Monkeys. So I was hosting a late night talk show.
I understand.
Where we talked, this is a way to give information, to do the book report. It was right. Like, this is a great movie. It was adapted from a book that's about this kid who goes into the woods and meets these. I basically read the back of the book, and that's the info. And then just did all this funny bullshit. And I go, let's have my buddy on. I go, Jonathan Taylor Thomas, let's bring him out.
Why don't we just cut to a clip? And he's,
well, hold on. My buddy comes out, and I go, Jonathan, so good to see you. I go, you look different.
Is that going to be on the clip?
I don't know, but what will be in the clip is me hosting the talk show.
We'll cut to it?
Yeah.
Send us away. Hi, I got a question. Do you want news made smart and simple? I certainly don't.
Rick,
Yes, you do. Everybody does. Hey, guys, it's me, John DeWalt, from TYSO Episode 1, the first time that Rick did the show, and the holiday, 8 Nights of TYSO. I was the least viewed one of those 8 that he did. What's up, man?
Hey, John.
Dude, in this era of war on information, of course you want your news made simple. That's why I'm here representing the Logically app, which combines sophisticated AI with human fact checkers like me and Rick. The app is free to use. It's blowing up with huge numbers. It's a very professional, legit app. Why aren't you wearing a suit? You look like shit. You're dressed horribly. You look like shit, dude. You look like ass.
Okay.
You gotta look better.
Okay.
And take it more seriously.
Oh, I think I get it. So you're saying Logically is helping by bringing the trust back to the poop?
Not trust back to the poop, Rick. Trust back to the news.
Oh.
Thank you so much, sweetheart.
So Logically gives you access to a team of dedicated fact checkers.
Bingo. And let's try it. This sitting with me right here is Ruth Bader Ginsburg eating M&Ms.
False.
I think my friend Rick is starting to get the picture.
So you as a user can submit reports and articles to the app to get checked?
Yeah, and if you didn't, you know what I would say? I would dissent.
Oh, yeah, I look at that. I like that. So there are credible sources to back up the verdict of the article. Download the Logically app today to have access to real fact checkers and receive news that's real.
And you want to know some news that's fake? We're not even here right now, Rick. This is all part of your crazy imagination because you're such a weird guy.
And then we'll do a crossfade. Download the Logically app today to have access to real fact checkers and receive news that's real. Available on Google Play and the App Store, or head over to logically.ai to find out more. Oh, and one more thing. I'm not even Rick.
I'm a baby. Thanks, Logically.
And we're back.
That was hilarious.
I gotta be on that. And my teacher goes, I feel like you could have done more. I go, yeah, you're not wrong. Spanish did videos all the time. One time just got a sombrero and a big mustache and stood outside of a Starbucks playing songs. You could tell how good I am. And I was just playing. was that an Italian guy? I don't do voices. You could tell. But I here's the voice I would do. I'd go, Feliz Navidad. And I'd play and sing outside the Starbucks. And then I'd point at people as they'd walk in and just sing about what they were wearing. And then we did this whole avant-garde fake documentary with black and white about the guy that was trying to earn a living outside the Starbucks. And then meets a woman. And then it went off into this whole thing. And then we were in the car and it was me and this woman. And it was a whole thing that got so far away from the project. And everyone in class is watching.
I can imagine.
Everyone in the class is watching like, the fuck? To me, it was so funny to start off being like, this is a Spanish class project, and that turns into like this weird short film. And at the end, my teacher, Mrs. Holbert, was like, okay, that was a waste of time.
Is that what you called it?
I called it a moment in time.
So. Oh, she fucked and burned you.
Yeah.
that's my kind of woman.
She was attractive. She was,
You ever sleep with one of your teachers?
No, but.
Never.
That was the teacher that probably, I think, a couple of the football players, because I would hear them talk about it, tried to.
What was your third grade teacher's name?
Robish.
That was the one you liked the most.
Oh, yeah.
You ever think about hitting her up when you got into college?
I kept in touch with Ms. Holbert a little bit.
I slept with my kindergarten, first, and second grade teacher in college and first year out of college.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
No, you didn't.
No. No.
Wow. That would be ridiculous.
It would be...
Redonkulous?
It would be... It would be.
Remember things like that. Who started those? Redonkulous. Or I'll see ya, wouldn't want to be ya.
Those two things don't have enough in common to me to kind of hypothesize around the origins. I'm sorry. Those are just things.
Hey, this is an A and B conversation, so why don't you see yourself out? Do that?
Where I'm from, it was why don't you see your way out of it? Mm. Yeah, there's also...
Talk to the hand. Because the face don't have the time.
Yeah. Yeah.
You snooze, you lose. That's a good one.
My saying in high school was, because I never drank, but I would always go to places and like
do games or arm wrestle people to get free food. Like I would go to Dairy Queen and arm wrestle the guys for earthquake milkshakes. I would go through the Burger King and
arm wrestle. You challenge the employees?
I was an unbelievable, for some reason, I'm very, very good at arm wrestling and could beat people that are super strong. And I wasn't that strong in high school. So I would like do this and like as this parlor trick and also be engaging with people. I remember through Burger King, I did it for Dragon Ball Z toys. I got like through the drive-through window. I did it all the time. I mean, 30, 40 times. I would do it at places, hotels, asking for upgrades.
Yeah.
It was just a thing that I would do. And what were we talking about? And I would make friends places. And I would just like, I would get to go in places. Then I started to notice that was the beginning of realizing, oh, you could get stuff from people you don't even know by being funny.
Yeah.
And I had a saying that was, you booze, you lose, you schmooze, you win.
Whoa.
And I've always been attracted to the schmooze. The art of my mother.
Yeah, the art of the schmooze.
The art of the mother. You probably, maybe for you as well.
1,000%.
Yeah, my mom sells perfume. And
to who?
To whom?
Penguin Orphans?
No, our Asian friend whom?
Is that a real friend?
You know, it, no, to, she doesn't.
There's a Vietnamese girl in my high school named Betch Ho. B-E-T-C-H apostrophe H-O apostrophe.
Yeah.
Betcho.
Bottom dollar, if I don't finish this story, then people are going to have to go to patreon.com to finish and hear the rest.
Yeah, hey.
But my mom, she works at different department stores, a Macy's, Dillard's, stuff like that.
I bet she's unbelievable.
So I would do it some summers with her and just have fun, mother, son, and...
daughter, father.
You know, whatever the cat's delight.
Mother, sister.
and she, she's a salesman, I feel like saying saleswoman is derogatory because is she an actor or an act? Is it an actor or an actress? Just saying
that
actor.
That one always gets me confused. Actor, right?
I think. I don't say doctoress.
Actor isn't the male form.
I don't know. You know, but then you look at things like usted, and then you think like, you know, there are gender terms, but everything's so fluid and confusing at the moment.
Yeah,
I just want to say my mom's a salesman, but then,
she doesn't have boobs.
So I'll say salesperson.
Yeah, I'm good with that.
You know what? I'm gonna say a sales mom.
That's actually the right term.
Yeah. So the woman that raised me is a sales. She's not just a mom. She's a sales mom.
What was her top selling perfume? And did
whatever it was she was pushing. Now here's what it is. Here's the thing. She is a sales mom, but she is very honest and just schmoozes and connects. And you watch her, dude, I would love to cut to a clip. Woman will come up and you know, there's still a bit of like, you got to like bark to get them over. You spray whatever, but she's there and usually waits. People come over or if they're looking at something and she'll come up and. What is that? Oh, you from Seattle? You know, and in like that or whatever. And she's not lying. She's talking about the thing, the scarf. Sometimes she might just be talking about the scarf and then not even pitch the thing, so they walk away. So I know my mom is just trying to connect with people. At least that's what it seems like.
And then
like.
They get so appreciative of the small talk, and they get invested. See, I'd be the opposite. I'd be like, you smell like shit. That'll fix that.
That's
$85.99.
Yeah, you're a sales dad. And those guys, there's a reason they don't sell perfume. They sell cars. But my mom, I'm working kind of, but I'm walking away, and I come in, and I just see my mom. There's a... like a crowd around her, like three or four people. Are they customers or is it an audience? And my mom,
like she's juggling on Venice Boulevard.
My mom is putting lotion on the other person's arm and said, because it smells different when it mixes with your oils and smell it. And there's just everyone, he loves it. And there's literally an audience around
That's
my mom doing it.
Incredible.
I don't remember what made me bring that up.
But my
mom's awesome.
She really is. You said booze.
Schmoozing.
Schmoozy booze.
Yeah.
And I think it's a very... you didn't drink, you booze, you lose, the schmoozing, that's the gift of gab. My mom has it too, which is why I think they need to see each other at some point because
it'd be fun to do a podcast with the four of us.
Be amazing. The gift of gab. What I learned from my mom is that how invaluable, huh?
The way you were stuttering over that is making it up.
What if I just started crying? Be a good way to end the podcast. Crying before noon. Haven't done that in a while.
All right, so your mom is the gift of gab.
get to Gab, and I'm sure that you picked up on the same thing with your mom. Seeing them go out of their way to chum it up with anybody and be good at it.
Making friends with strangers type of thing.
A great skill set to have, especially in our business, where you're in places and positions where you're like, you know, whether you are aware that a contact, making connections, you always hear about that in the business. Oh, making connections, good at whatever.
But and it's always from a creepy guy, too.
He's going over there, talk to that guy.
It's always a Sandler impersonator right out of a bush.
That was one of the clips in Summer of the Monkeys. When I go, let's cut to a clip. My buddy just, who was, we literally put him outside in the backyard in some bushes. And he like reached through the bushes and then turned back and goes, where are the monkeys? And then I come back to me and I go, wow, I cannot wait to see that.
Cut to a clip.
I don't know if we have that clip.
Oh.
I'll find it though.
We'll cut to it.
but it's an acquired skill set, and I don't know how long it took you to get comfy.
I feel like it's genetic.
Yeah.
I feel like,
are you comfy talking to people you haven't met? If you're not doing a bit.
Yeah.
If you're not doing a bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
What's your tactic? For the listeners, how do you ease into a conversation with a stranger?
Here's what it is. You know, there's this, I'm going to answer this with a little, something a little broader. There's this stigma against trying. Don't try. It's fucking not cool to try.
You can tell.
There's something about being and not trying that's attractive, but there's also something about trying because that's respected. So finding that balance of when are you trying because it's...
The yawn was coincidental, but also appropriate.
Yeah, that did make me feel a little...
No. It's early. I slept 4.5 hours.
I don't know.
I took a bath last night with a guy.
When I see somebody, if my intention is just to like say something to them, yeah, it's not going to work.
Yeah.
But if I notice somebody has a cool pair of shoes or I'm in a silly mood and they look like a character, I want them to play something or whatever it is. Yeah. If I really want to connect with this person for something, then it's just, I think it translates that you're not lying to them. You're not trying to fuck with them and you're just connecting. Like when we played air volleyball on the beach, if I said, hey, I bet we could get these guys to fucking look like they're playing volleyball. They don't know what the fuck we're, hey, guess, and pretending to be something. But I really wanted to play some volleyball with them. And I think it translates.
Eat shit!
Suck on the mat.
Sorry.
Good play.
Yeah, good play by the ass. 2-0 game point.
So I think the trick is know what you want, be kind to those around you, and trust the movement. This is Adam Ray on Trust the Movement.
Trust the movement. Trust the movement. Oh, 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 trust the movement. Because if you're scared, don't be afraid. Go on that beach and play air volleyball any day. With a stranger, there's no danger in opening your heart and your mind. Because you don't know.
That's Adam Ray on Trust the Movement. I hope you guys learned something from this. This series, this sleepover series, it's that sleepovers aren't just for little boys or little girls. Sleepovers are for friends. Whether you're... Oh, you know, I should maybe...
Having a sleepover is fun.
It's silly to think that you can't ask a friend to sleep over just because they have a kid or... You only have a one-bedroom apartment. Because at the end of the day, don't you want to be with your best friends? Think about it this way. You could wake up and have a muffin, or you could wake up, have a laugh. And hell, you could have some muffins too. I know a girl who was once a little scared to introduce herself to the pretty girls. Her mother told her she was so beautiful, but she didn't listen. She wanted those pretty curls. Whether your hair is straight or bright or dark or light or curly or straight or high, to bait the others to think that you can't be original. We must learn to love ourselves, learn to love our wealth, not just who we are outside, but everything that makes us well. We're human, we're different, we're the same, we're bait out. I'll tell you, I'm just so sad inside. So this little girl grew up, she became Bill Gates and invented Apple with Wozniak inside of a garage. And then she got some sickness and she left us too soon. But baby, if I tell you I remember her, I wouldn't be lying to ya. She created the iPhone. She created a way to connect through iMessage. And I don't know if she invented the emoticon, but she did help a culture learn to communicate in ways through text that allow you to feel, not just read. Whether it's Bill Gates or Amelia Earhart, it doesn't matter how pretty you are. What matters is if you accomplish something unbelievable, whether it's traveling around the world or letting me speak to somebody from the other side of the world by a snap of the finger. It doesn't matter. Otherwise, you should be good looking. Because if you can't bring me an iPhone or you can't fly me to New Zealand, you better be able to suck me off, beautiful. Or jerk me off.
Ooh, or jerk me off.
We have to fill 4 more minutes.
And that's how the iPhone was created. What'd you learn, kids? Who hired this public speaker?
That's this. There's so many stock jokes, like when people either follow somebody who was dirty or they themselves were dirty, and they go, "And I do children's parties."
Yeah, yeah.
But that's a fresh take on it.
Thanks, public speaker.
Yeah,
yeah. We had a motivational speaker in high school. This guy came. Never forget this.
Jesus, in front of everybody,
in his pants, and his three main talking points were: get sweaty, do it if it feels good, and don't take no for an answer. Hear me out. My first thing, get sweaty. All that means, I need a big projector with a PowerPoint. He goes, get sweaty. What that means is get after it. Get into it. Put in the time. Put in the effort. And make sure that you're earning what you're grinding for. Number two, do it if it feels good. I'm talking, if something feels good and you're doing it and you're loving it and it's putting a smile on your face, keep on doing it. Number three, don't take no for an answer. These are the times to fucking not listen to any of the haters. Just listen to what's inside of yourself. If you think you can do something, go for it. So, to review, get sweaty. Do it if it feels good. Don't take no for an answer. And we're all sitting there like, hey, man. Don't you think your points are a little aggressive? Don't you think you're saying some weird stuff? Don't you think you're teaching us to be bad people? Don't you think you should change your ways? Who hired this speaker today? Who hired this guy anyway? I don't like his shoes. I'm not a fan of his hat.
I don't know the melody.
And his legs.
I don't know the melody.
Look kind of fat. What?
I don't know the melody, really, what's going on there. And I really wanted to, because I feel like I actually have a good voice in a low register, but it's just really silly.
Yeah.
So people think I'm joking. But it's like I'm
showing my real
self. Are you trying
to harmonize with the lawnmower?
That's a cool nickname. How long have you been asking people to call you that?
That's fucking funny. That was me in 30 years sitting outside of a coffee shop and a kid walks in. I go, you ever harmonized with a lawnmower? And he goes,
I'm not going to be able to connect to those kids at all.
The lawnmower is a great nickname for like a Tom Petty-esque guy who sings, you know, he's got originals. He's outside of a coffee shop being like, hey, you guys want to hear a little ditty? They go, no, not really.
Maybe some Tupac.
Yeah. Well, I got something pretty much the same.
Puff Daddy. Ooh. Maybe I should have said Biggie. She said Biggie. I was just trying to do a Tupac callback from early in the episode, but Biggie. I still, you figured it's a similar genre.
Did you guys?
The connection's not that far.
What if he does a little song about the kids, getting them free? He's like got subliminal.
How are you on time? You have to get to your VO.
2 minutes. Subliminal message if he's like, you guys want to hear a little song? Like, yeah, for sure. We don't have much time, old man. Hey, 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 I'm only 75. You can get a lot done before you're 80. Here's the song.
Was that like a saying, the way you said that?
Yeah, yeah.
You said it like there was a...
Everything at 75 sounds like an old saying. If you put enough into it.
Right. It's like, excuse me, can somebody help me up? I have to use the bathroom.
Yeah. It's all about delivery. And so
it's a lot about delivery.
They go, what
it's not all about delivery.
Easy UPS. So then, or easy Pizza Hut.
See?
Use one of those. So he's
one minute.
His song to the guys, to the kids, is just him asking for shit. So he's like,
okay,
I got an original song. Could you guys get me a muffin or a pastry from the store?
That's funny.
Bring it outside and leave it next to my feet on the bottom of the floor. But don't get me that chocolate chip bullshit. I'm allergic to nuts. So I can't believe I'm talking to you.
Oh, no.
And they just burns them. The kids go, fuck you. And he goes, oh, fuck you. Well, fuck me too.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
I was liking it because it felt like that'd be really funny. Yeah. I'd easily get that guy a muffin and put it down below on his feet. May I?
I can't believe I'm giving up my knock guitar. Oh, feels weird. No, take it.
Well,
it.
I don't.
I'm just weird about people using guitars that aren't mine that I've just been playing for a minute.
Yeah, I understand. I want to bring the piano in.
Oh, we got to get that going.
I'm moving. We'll have a new set soon, and I want to have the piano so I could use it on the podcast and do stuff.
Got to.
Because I don't really know how to play this that well.
Oh, man. Why weren't you playing longer?
I really don't. I only know a few things. I don't remember the David Wayne character in Role Models where he's going. Wait, no.
Oh, he just does it.
No, that's not it. Hold on one second. And it's like for like 20 seconds. It's like a. It's not that long, but it's just like a so downbeat.
Saying I love you is not the words I want to hear from you. It's not that I want. How easy it could be to show.
Wait, that's not it. Wait.
More than what?
I have TMJ disorder, and I should be lower.
It's all good, it's all good.
But I really do have a good voice. Watch, listen to my lower register. I'm serious.
I'm the girl you're trying to impress me in the dorm room.
I've been that playing this with you for 30 minutes.
You have TMJ?
Listen how good for real my lower register is.
Me gusta jugar al fútbol. Puedo ir al baño.
Would you dance? No, that's not a good song for it.
Would you dance?
Would you dance?
There it is.
Dance? If I asked you to dance.
There it is.
Wait, is there a capo? Would.
Here, I'm right here. Would you dance?
Would you dance?
Yep.
Puedo ir. E me gusta me antios con mosua e duro e toi.
Duro e toi.
Would you tremble? If I touch your lips,
kiss.
Would you save my soul tonight?
Or tomorrow, whatever works best for you.
Would you tremble?
Would you tremble?
If I touch your lips again.
Put your face next to mine.
Would you run?
Stay right here.
Please tell me this.
Do you have proper shoes for outside?
Would you die for the one you love?
Would you die for the one you love, is what he said.
Would you hold my soul tonight?
My soul tonight. I think that means hold, but or have in the same word.
I would be your
I don't know how it goes. I don't know my fingers. I haven't played with my pinkies hurt.
So TMJ.
Yeah.
Got TMJ of the
knuckle. A little too much juice. No, but Adam, it's really great to have you. As you know, you're one of the favorite, you're the most fantastic guest we could ever have, most we could ever ask for. Before you go, I ask all my guests, you're no stranger to this, but I have three questions, and you have to just rapid fire, answer the first thing that comes to your head.
Do it.
Question number one, pee or poo?
Pee.
Question number two, now this is a tough one, boxers or briefs?
Boxers.
Question number three, okay, as quickly as you can, what do you think we could do to best fix systemic racism in our country?
Oh, man, just take all the racists. You know who you are. Put them on a ship, send them out to an island, and just call it, like, Ignorant Island,
Who's paying for this?
Not the taxpayers. The
private?
Trump's, once he gets...
Why would Trump's people pay for this?
I don't know, because they have created a lot of the
mess.
Have
you really not put real thought into this? We obviously can't we can't deport them. Oh, there's no way to prove objectively.
I think that's the move. I think you see people, what they've posted, who they are. You go door to door and you simply ask, you go,
that's totalitarianism.
Are white people better? And they go, yeah. And I need and Obama's taking my haircuts and my root beer floats. And you go, all right, we're going to put you
was
on
that the Bernie Mac?
No. And you put them on a ship and you send them off to Ignorant Island.
All right.
And,
well, I'll tell you what I do on Patreon. If you want to hear what we could do, both about boxers, briefs, pisses, and shits, and what we could do about the current climate that we're in, that I don't have the fix, but I do have some thoughts on how we could come together as a people, go to patreon.com/takeyourshoesoff. Adam, you've been unbelievable.
It's been a blast.
I don't know if we should touch.
Great.
Cut to a montage of us holding hands, taking baths. Yeah. And do you care if it's funny? People, it's a joke. When we were when you were you. We'll cut to a clip. Did you know that I did that? Were you being?
I feel like that's not content you should have out there.
All right, I'll bleep it all out. Bleep that one too. My name's Rick Glassman.
My name's Adam Ray.
And I'm Rick Glassman. All right, that was good. Now this is just the last five or 10 seconds when the credits are going, and they can't really hear us, but we're doing the. And physicality is a big thing to see. It looks like, what are they talking about?